I think that I am turning into a hardcore gamer, if you guys get the joke. Like the video, please. Anyways, there is this new platform that people are starting to talk about. And I'm like, oh, okay, whatever, let's go check it out, and let's go play some games. And oh my gosh, guys, you are going to love this, okay? Who knows? Maybe Toad's gonna transition from Roblox to Core. So hey, Core, if you're watching this and you wanna sponsor me, please sponsor me, and I will make a ton of videos on your platform. Anyways, we are here today. We are playing some cool little games on Core. This one that I'm playing right now is called Honey Magnate, and it's basically exactly what you guys think it is. It is Bee Swarm Simulator, but like 3D version. It looks super cool, and it's like very, very, very similar to the game, but it plays super well. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what the new and improved Core Games Bee Swarm Simulator is like. So please smash the like button and let's check it out. Okay, so when you first join the game, you're gonna land here. There is a really good tutorial that tells you where you need to go. It does everything for you. But you're gonna go over here, just like Bee Swarm Simulator, you're going to attack the area. What I really like about this game is that you can attack really fast, which is awesome. So look, boom, and you get the bombs, just like Bee Swarm Simulator Roblox, and you destroy things, and you collect your honey. So I've actually been playing this game for about, I'm gonna say it's been 3 hours straight. I've been 3 hours of non-stop grinding this game, guys, which has been quite a lot of time. So please like the video and I hope you enjoy it. But yeah, and this is the result. I've unlocked a ton of things that I can show to you guys. I definitely haven't beaten the game. I'm nowhere near on a leaderboard, if there is a leaderboards, but okay, so collect your honey. Once you collect your honey, you're gonna go over here to the side little statue. You're gonna claim one and you're gonna stand right there, and your bees are gonna take your pollen from your backpack and transfer it over there into the honey stacks area. So boom, we're getting our honey. With honey, Toad, what can you buy? Just like in Bee Swarm Simulator, you can buy a couple of super cool things. This takes a while, not gonna lie, so. All right, okay, are you done yet? Hey, come finish. Look at the graphics, first of all. Look at the graphics in this game. This is insane. This is all Core. They all look like this, super hyper realistic and very, very cool. Look at the bees buzzing around. Okay, when you have enough honey, you're gonna go over here to the shop and you're gonna get yourself better backpacks, better pizza, Papa John's, and a better pickaxe. But a harvesting tool, you can upgrade your backpack. I've upgraded my backpack to level 16 and my harvesting tool to level 10. I think I'm gonna upgrade my harvesting tool next again, but it is nice to have a bigger backpack. So, am I gonna do that? I'll do it for you guys. There we go. I upgraded my harvesting tool. So as you guys saw, it now collects 4 pollen from 11 flowers, which is basically 44. And then some, because you guys, your bees are gonna do something for you as well. They're gonna give you like a multiplier. So back to my hive, I will show you what my bees can do. I've found some pretty cool bees already. Click F to train your bees. Right here, there's a VIP game pass at the bottom that you guys can get. I don't necessarily suggest you guys get it because it did cost 199 of these like Core coins, and 199 Core coins is basically like $2.50. So I basically spent $2.50 to get super strong. But for the next 7 days of grinding, I'm gonna get 3 times mutagen from the fountain, which I will show you guys where that is, and 2 times honey from pollen. Very, very helpful. That 2 times honey is so strong. There's also supporter pack, but that's kind of expensive. That's like $12-$13 worth, and I don't have that much. You do get a flying mount and 300,000 honey though, so that's quite a lot if you're trying to start the game. And then the 200 mutaguns, that's like buying this 2 times through, which is quite a lot actually. So if I had 999, I would, but hey, Core, if you're watching this, please sponsor me. Anyways, over here, when you go into this menu area, you see there's a thing that says hatch bee. So I'm gonna go ahead and hatch a new bee. There we go, I hatched the bee, and then it's all the way at the bottom there. That's my 13th bee, so I've been playing this game for quite a while. You're gonna mutagate it, and I got an uncommon. See, 90%, 9%, and 1%. That's what it looks like right there. The designs of the bee are pretty cool. I think they could look a little bit cooler, but they're cool. Let's go ahead and mutate it again. We got another uncommon. Actually, I need white bees, so I'm gonna leave that the way it is. And then there's another blue bee here. Oh, it turned into a white mega. Yes. Okay, that's awesome. Okay, the white megas here, guys, give you like a pollen collection that's a lot higher. Honey transformation, and you collect and you get like extra special bombs. Like the bombs that show up on the map here, it's all because of like these mega these. Oh my gosh, we're getting so much stuff. There you go. There's a bond right there. There's a bond right there. Here on this area, there's this like get mutagem area. Since I have the VIP, I get 3 times the amount, but you can just sit here AFK, guys. That's a big thumbs up from me. 3 every 30 minutes. So if I go to sleep for like, let's say 6 hours, that's 12 times 3. That's 36 mutagems that I can get from just sitting here AFK. I don't know if you need an auto clicker to stay AFK overnight, but here's to hoping you don't. But yeah, and then so once you've like kind of beaten this area, there's kind of a thing right here that says like, oh look, zone 1, which requires 5 Ds, which I've also gotten. Before we do that, there's a restaurant. Sorry, I forgot to show you guys a restaurant. You can buy D food here. I'm gonna go ahead and get a couple just because I need to upgrade that B anyways. With the D food, you go ahead and go back to your Bs, and your Bs are gonna be more productive. They're gonna do more stuff for you, and they're gonna be really, really helpful. So go back here, same thing, click F to train your Bs. That D's already level 5, so I don't need to level it up anymore. This one's level 3, that's level 1. Let's level that up real quick. Level this one. Let's try to mutate this again. Red B. Oh, we got another white mega! Okay, this is like pretty insanely lucky. All I have is white Bs, and then I have two mega reds, so I don't even have a blue B. So what I suggest, what's been helping me out a lot, is getting one specific type of B, because what I'm about to show you is really helpful. Let's go ahead and just like try to mutate this one. Oh, I got a red one. Okay, go back over here into zone 2. Once you unlock zone 2, you're gonna get this thing right here that I'm riding. It's like a cool little mount, and you go so much faster, and it's so helpful. But zone 2, here we are. First thing you see is this guy here. He is the White Clan, so he's kind of cool. There's all these rewards you get for completing the quest. 5 reputation and 5,000 honey for collecting 27,000 white pollen. And then there's also the red one down this way here. There you go. You talk to him. I'm only level 2 on him, so I got quite a ways to go to get strong with him. Like I said, I'm focusing on the white bees right now, so that's why I'm already level 20 reputation with this, which is pretty cool. But there's like really no massive reward that you're going to get for going through. It's just the same thing, mutagens, mutagens, mutagens. And then on this side, you are going to get this blue bird right here. And this is the blue clan. I've also only done 2, so that's pretty cool. But look at this, the blue clan has a blue area. So if I had a bunch of blue bees, I can just sit there and farm and get a lot of cool stuff. Going back, since I got the White Clan stuff, I actually go straight across over here to this area, which is the White Pollen area. And just doing this nonstop has helped me so much. Like, look at this. Hey, look at all these bombs at my Mega D spawn. It's quite insane, actually. I do kind of want those 200 mutagens that you get from like the special pack, but it's quite expensive, so I won't be able to get that just yet. But look, all these bombs help me get so much pollen so fast. I also did notice one thing that I haven't told you guys yet. These bombs actually scale with whatever your like pickaxe or honey picker is. So you see how I'm getting +4 for swinging? Well, the bombs also explode for +4. So upgrade your pickaxe if you want to get a better bomb reward, which I suggest you work on. I just haven't gotten to that yet because it takes a lot of grinding to get to the point around that. 10,000. Boom, boom, boom. Let's go. I'm trying to complete this white quest. And then I'm going to show you guys one more secret thing. There's these 5 hidden gates, which will unlock something very cool that you guys are gonna love. So smash the like button. Actually, you might hate me, but we'll show you guys. It's a secret. It's definitely a secret. Go. I love how you can ride your mount too. That's a very nice feature that Bubblegum Sim doesn't have. You have to kind of like pick up the coins in Bubblegum Sim on Roblox. This one, you can just kind of ride your mount indefinitely, which helps you move so much faster and is so much more ideal for grinding. Yeah, okay. Boom. Almost there. Like I said, guys, the grind is OP. you're going to be grinding here quite a bit. So if you like grindy games and you like games like Bubblegum Simulator, Beastborn Simulator, you're going to want to join Core and start playing. I'm telling you guys, hey, Core, please sponsor Toad, please. I'll make more videos and I'll, yeah, okay. Doom, 26,000, and there we go. We got 5,000 honey and one Mutagon for completing that one quest, which, as you guys saw, only took me like a minute max. So there we go. We are level 22 reputation. We're gonna get 6,100 for next thing, but we'll go back and show you guys the last thing, which is the 5 hidden doors. You see this right here, right in front of me, this door. If you walk up to him, it says boom, receive a blessing. So there's our first blessing. Here is the second blessing, and then the third blessing is all the way over here behind near the red area. I think, hold on, I might be confused. I think I've confuzzled myself. One, two. Oh, the third blessing's over here. I like, it's near the white area. There we go. There's the third blessing. The last two blessings are actually back in the main world, so we're gonna zoom our way there as quickly as we can. Boom, boom, boom. There is the fourth one right there. It's called Kirk. And then the last blessing is right here, Mr. Arudo. Boom, collect his blessing. And now we've collected all 5 blessings, and I'll show you guys where you need to go to get your blessing rewards. And then that'll be the end of the video. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. You see that portal right there? It says, collect 5 blessings to activate portal. VIP for free. Just go. You deserve it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want to see more of this. Oh gosh, I forgot my camera's in there. But yeah, you see there's the quest right there. And yeah, maybe more Core gaming coming from Toad soon. Okay, I'll see you later. Reese's Pieces. Bye.